lot of retrospective thinking towards guns following the tragic shooting in Arizona on the weekend of January 8th, 2011. We're here in the streets of New York City to find out what's going on in people's heads.
Hi, good afternoon. Do you guys have a second to talk about gun control in America? Jared Loughner?
No, sorry.
Okay.
No, we don't.
Okay. Excuse me, we're talking to people about Jared Loughner and world gun control?
No, sorry.
Okay.
Excuse me, can I ask you guys a few questions?
No.
Excuse me, ma'am? Oh, sorry, you're on the phone. Sorry. You can't tell. Excuse me, do you guys have a second to talk about gun control and Jared Loughner? Okay. They didn't actually say anything. She just went, I.
It's really difficult to get people to talk about this.
Do you have a second to chat? Okay. Yeah. Do you have a second? We'd love to hear your opinion about world gun control.
Okay.
You heard about Jared Loughner in the Arizona shooting. Do you have any thoughts on that or any thoughts about gun control and should they be stricter or less strict and its comparison from America's gun control to the world's gun control?
Obviously, it needs to be stricter. We have the highest homicide rate in any of the industrial countries. We're, 5.4 compared to France, which is like 2-point-something or other, and Great Britain, which is even lower.
It's hard for me to form a one-sided opinion on the gun control laws just because it's such a double-edged blade kind of thing. It's like, you know, you look at other countries that have very strict control and don't allow people to own firearms. And I think if we implemented that sort of thing in this country, it wouldn't be. I mean, just look at the drug trade. It's illegal. People still get it.
It's a major issue the U.S. has with gun control. It's like way years, in my opinion, years behind many other countries. Just because way too relaxed, and you put too much trust into people being careful, and like clearly it's the wrong attitude because you can go into Walmart and buy ammunition and like weapons like too easily, much too easily.
Go into the communities and teach the kids when they're younger. I would say have stronger gun control because honestly, you know, even though we lock up people and take all these firearms and we have all these gun drives for toys and whatnot, you'll still find a way to get those guns that were collected back on the street because money talks and people are crooked, and especially the people who are here to protect us.
The weapons, they're dangerous, and it should take more than a couple of days waiting period to get a hold of one.
Yeah.
So, you know.
Do you think that they should institute more kind of personal checks on each person?
And now I recognize there's a slippery slope in terms of the legality of this, which makes it just easier to outlaw it altogether. And you know, there's a history in this country about protecting yourself and stuff like that. But, you know, I don't think these laws or the right to bear arms, it's a product of an era where it was important. We live in a different sort of society. And I think laws should change a little bit with time.
I think there was one of the people that detained Jared. He was actually carrying a gun, and he switched the safety off, but didn't use it in his apprehension.
Okay, but you can't really, I don't know. And criminals are going to get weapons regardless of where they are, like regardless of the conditions of control. Because even in Canada, like, people have guns, and they're sold just as cheaply as they are here. And we have very strict laws. It's nearly impossible to get a hunting rifle in Canada or in like a Scandinavian country or something where you're allowed to hunt, but the process and the background checks involved are so much more extensive. I don't know. I wouldn't put that much trust in the people, regardless if you're an ex-Marine, like an ex-military, something. Like, no, you shouldn't have a gun.
I mean, I wouldn't feel safe having a police force that didn't have weaponry.
And on the other hand, I think a lot of times people focus so much on what we have the right to do here and not to be like other countries that are so restrictive on your rights that they overlook just general human safety.
I've got some family that live in Oklahoma, and I was actually quite shocked at how free it was for them to walk into a store and buy a weapon. I mean, we walked out 10 minutes later, he had a shotgun in his hand, and I was just, it freaked me out because I was like, wow.
That's
like anyone can just walk into a store and buy a gun. As long as you've got a clean criminal background, that doesn't mean you're not going to go insane 5 years down the road, you know?
There's always going to be a way to get them, regardless if there's a law or not.
So, thinking of that, there's always humans are always going to do what they want to do. What do you guys think that we could do to make this a safer place?
That's a good question.
I don't even know.
You can't control people. Like, right. People don't care. They do it anyway.
And they get mad if you try to control them.
Yeah, and it just makes the situation worse.
And it's not a big problem in New York, but, you know, in certain places in this country, it's fairly easy to get a gun.
This last summer, there was 3 shootings in a span of over 2 weekends. There was one that was actually right down the block. A little kid was shot. This was last summer. And then in the club over here, somebody got shot. And then there was another club over on B, somebody got shot.
I'm sure if it was any other country, this could happen in any other country. People shoot up places in India, like Pakistan, France. Like, you can't really control. People could be crazy wherever you are.
The building that we live in, one of the guys actually committed suicide on Wednesday and lit the building on fire right beforehand.
So he killed himself with a firearm?
Yes.
It's about concentration. The fact that it gets abstracted and turned into kind of a masturbatory exercise of just meaningless violence is a really, really sad fact, but I don't think that has anything, there's no connection between that and when it's used responsibly.
The right people need guns, that's what that's about it. Everyone, people walking the street shouldn't carry them, just, you know, NYPD, that's about it really.
Opinions on gun control are as varied as the different types of people in America. Everyone admits it's an issue, but personally, I don't know if I like or do not like gun control. All I know is that when the apocalypse hits, I don't want to be the only one without a gun. Jessica Mermelstein reporting for AboveTopSecret.com.